consignment bills for several Republicans who each want to be president of the United States. But before they get there, they must go through Ohio primary voters first.
I hope to win in Ohio. No predictions, but it feels good at this point. Again, it's an uphill battle.
Mitt Romney is back to frontrunner status, leading in delegates after winning Tuesday in both Arizona and Michigan. 1144 is the magic number for Republicans. Romney has 146 delegates after his two wins this week. Santorum has moved into second place with 49. Gingrich drops to third with 34. And Ron Paul remains at 27 delegates.
It's a good weather vane as to where Republicans are going across the country. And that's why we're planting our flag here and trying to do well.
Rick Santorum is a social conservative who's unapologetic in his view that he and not Romney is in the mainstream of the Republican Party. Next week, Santorum hopes to build on delegates, 437 of them up for grabs, a huge day, Super Tuesday, Alaska, Georgia, Idaho, Massachusetts, North Dakota, Oklahoma, Tennessee, Vermont, Virginia, along with Ohio.
This race is going to be very, very, I think, significant. It may well go all the way to the convention, and I'm committed to being in it and to competing in Ohio.
Romney, Santorum, and Gingrich know that Ohio is critical in the fall, but few knew at the start of the year how important it would be in the primary. Now Santorum is pushing the debate to the right, championing conservative social issues.
Someone better be talking about that, because we're not going to have limited government. We're not going to have lower taxes. We're not going to have a strong community if we continue to see the family break down in America because of the rampant amount of sexual activity among our teens.
While Santorum feels at ease discussing issues like abortion, women in combat, and religion, there's one topic that Romney believes should have been left out of the debate.
The idea of presidential candidates getting into questions about contraception within a relationship between a man and a woman, a husband and wife, I'm not going there.
Another area of disagreement between Romney and Santorum has been over the issue of congressional earmarks.
For Governor Romney to throw that out, it's just the hypocrisy. I think people get tired of that.
And him, you know, throwing around names, if he called me a hypocrite, but what an outrageous thing to say.
For Gingrich, he's consistently run third in polls from Ohio. His hope is a come-from-behind victory fueled by his new energy plan.
The fact is, Ohio's on the verge of a renaissance of energy production in both natural gas and oil, and it's going to make a lot of people very successful.
While Gingrich's success Tuesday night is far from certain, one thing is clear. Super Tuesday is unlikely to settle the GOP race, and this fight will go on. Covering campaign 2012, Jim Heath, The Ohio News Network.